Hey, what's up guys? It's Yvonne, and in this video I want to show you how to set up Google Ads call conversion tracking here with their new interface. Now I'm going to show you how to do it two ways. The first way is if we just want to track clicks on our site, whether somebody's on their phone or on the computer. If somebody clicks on the phone number on your site, we want that to trigger a conversion. The second way I'm going to show you to track call conversions is if you want to measure a certain duration of a phone call. So if somebody stays on the phone with you for over 40 seconds or over 60 seconds or over 2 minutes, whatever amount you want in seconds, we're going to be able to set that up so that only if somebody stays on the phone with you for that specific time, only then will that be considered a conversion. All right. So we will be using Google Tag Manager here for this. I strongly suggest you guys set it up for your site. It makes it incredibly easy to set up conversion tracking, not just for Google Ads, but for anything really. And it allows you to set up sophisticated tracking as well. Okay. So we're going to use Google Tag Manager. If you don't have it, that's okay. I'll briefly guide you how to set it up, but that's pretty much all we need. And we're going to be using this website here, dynamicgrowthagency.com, as an example. And we're going to be tracking this phone number here. Okay. So we're going to be tracking how many people click on this number. And then when somebody calls, we want to be able to track how many people stay online with you after a certain duration. All right. So let's get into it. So first of all, if you don't have Google Tag Manager, just head over to tagmanager.google.com and set it up. It might ask you a few questions. Just answer those questions. Super, super easy. Then you're going to get a code that's going to look like this. So if you exited that pop-up too early, then just click on it again over here in your Google Tag Manager account, and you will see the code that you need to add to your website. We're using WordPress in this example, but whatever page builder you're using, it does not matter. Just add these in the head and the body section of your website. If you're not sure where to add it, leave the comments below and I'll do the best I can to help you. So with WordPress, we're just going to install a plugin. It's called WP Code Lite. Very, very simple. And then once you install and activate that plugin, you're going to see an option here in the bottom left that says code snippets. Just click on header and footer and you will add this Google Tag Manager code over here. So you're going to add the top part in the header and the bottom part here in the body. And that is it. You're going to hit save and you'll be good to go. Okay. So that's it for the Google Tag Manager setup part, adding it to your site at least. So now let's head back over into our Google Ads account. And trust me, you're going to thank me later for showing you how to set up this Google Tag Manager setup. It's going to make your life so much easier here with conversion tracking. So let's go to goals. Let's go to summary and we're going to click on create conversion action. We're going to jump around here between Google Ads and Google Tag Manager. So in fact, I'll probably move these a little closer to each other. And so the first thing we want to do is track just the clicks on the button. Okay. So in this case, on this site, we want to track just how many people click the button here, which will prompt them to open an app. Because I'm on my computer, it's asking me to prompt an app to pick. And on the phone, people will be able to call you right away. They won't need to pick an app, obviously. So let's come back into here. And for this first option here, we're going to disable conversions from phone calls. We're just going to track conversions on a website because we want to track the clicks. Now, in this case, it has the wrong website over here. So if your website is correct and you've set up the Google Tag Manager as I showed you, then this should say installed. If not, and you want to double check, just click on edit, enter the right website, which is dynamicgrowthagency.com. And this is the site on which we're testing the setup. So let's just click done. And it should not give you any error messages here. Okay, so let's click on continue. And then here's where we're going to give the category to this conversion. So in this case, we're tracking a contact, right? People that tries to contact us by clicking on the phone number on our site. So we're going to say contact. Don't worry about the Zapier integration. And this is the event in question. So we're going to click on setup over here. We're going to say create manual event. We're going to give a name for this conversion. So we're going to say, let's say phone call clicks. We're going to say use event. And now we're going to come in here, click on settings. And the first question here it's asking is, do you want this to be used as primary or secondary action? So this is used if you have many different conversions that you want to track. Let's say you're tracking leads, you're tracking sales, upsells, phone calls. What is the primary one that you want Google to optimize your traffic for? So in this case, for example, we are a service-based industry and the only thing we're doing on our site is having our phone number to collect those leads. So in this case, we're going to leave it at primary. Then we're going to go through here, the conversion name, we're going to leave the value as is, and for the count, we're going to leave as one. So if one person calls us five times in a short time frame, we want that to be considered one call, right? We don't want that to be five different phone calls. And everything else we're going to leave as is. Now I cover all of these different options here in very thorough detail, including the ones up here in my membership site at ivanmana.com/marketing-blueprint. But for the purpose of this video, we're going to leave this as default. We're going to click on done over here, and we have everything we need. So we're going to click on save and continue. And now we just have to go and finish up the steps on the Google Tag Manager side. So we're going to select use Google Tag Manager. As you can see here, it makes things super, super easy. And we need this conversion ID and the conversion label. So let's jump back over into our Google Tag Manager. Let's click on tags. Let's click on new over here. Let's give this a name. So let's say Google Ads. Let's say phone call clicks. And then for the tag configuration, we're going to select Google Ads, and we're going to select Google Ads conversion tracking. And then we need to enter the conversion ID, conversion label, and these are optional. So let's come back here. Let's copy this conversion ID. And let's copy the conversion label. Now, the conversion label is specific to this specific conversion. The conversion ID is for your entire account. Now, if you have a message that says that your Google tag isn't installed, simply click on install, click on the button, and then click save. They do everything for you automatically, so there's nothing that I need to talk about and nothing that you need to do. Just if you get the message that says Google tag isn't installed, just click on install and then save that tag that they automatically create for you. That is all. Now, in terms of conversion value, you can of course enter a value. If you work backwards and you know how many phone calls it takes for you to make a sale, for example, then you can come in here and enter the value. You can enter transaction ID, currency code. In our case, we do have these custom values that repopulate automatically depending on the actual value. So I'm going to input these in, but it's absolutely not necessary for you to do so. So these will be dynamically updated depending on the actual sale. But again, these are optional. You can just leave these all blank because it is just a phone call. It's not an actual sale, right? We're going to leave everything else as is. Now we need to add a trigger. So when do we want this tag to fire? Well, when somebody clicks on that button, right? So in this case, I already have some different options like this phone call click over here, but let's suppose you don't have it. How do you set it up? We're going to click on plus over here. We're going to give this a name. So we're going to say phone call click. I might already have that. Let's say YouTube again. I have different triggers like that. We're going to select it. We're going to say just links because we don't want to track every single click on the site, right? We want to track just specific link clicks, just some link clicks. We're going to select the variable, which is going to be click URL contains, and then we're going to say tell. Okay. And the reason we're doing it this way is if we go back to the website here, if I hover over this number here, or at least the hyperlink for this number, and the bottom left, you see there it says tell double dots plus 1-800, right? Or if we scroll down over here, if I hover over this phone number here at the bottom left there, you see again, it says tell double dots, right? 123. So the way the browser or the mobile phone knows that it's a phone number that's about to be called is with those three letters there, T-E-L, standing for telephone, right? And the double dots. So that when you click on it, it prompts us to pick an app. And so that's why we're adding, as long as the click URL contains this tell, that's when we want this tag to trigger. Okay, so we're going to click save, and this is what we've set up. So this tag will fire and will transmit information over to Google Ads for this conversion label for this account when somebody clicks on any link that has tell in front of it. Okay, so that's what we're doing here. If you want this to fire only on specific pages, you can do so. You can just click here and add an additional trigger. And then you can say, for example, you want it to be on the pricing page, or you can add a new page and say page URL contains this. Okay, I cover all this in very thorough detail in my membership site. Check it out. But for now, we're just doing this on your entire site, which is more than good enough, I'd say. So let's click save over here, and that is good over here. So let's click on last edited and find our tag. It's right here. So before we actually test it, let me go ahead and show you how to set up this other conversion, and then we're going to come in and test both of them together. That's one of the beauties of Google Tag Manager, is that you'll be able to preview all the changes and make sure that they're all working before you actually start sending the traffic. All right. So for this other conversion, let's go back into Google Ads. Let's click finish. Let's click on create new conversion action here. And then for this one, we will say conversions from phone calls, and we're gonna choose this option, calls from website visits, okay? Calls from ads allows you to add call extensions, which is super easy, but let me know in the comments if you want me to make a video on that. By far, the more challenging are the two call conversions that I'm showing you how to do in this video. So we're gonna choose this option here, conversions from phone calls. We're gonna click on continue. And then again, we're gonna give the category for this conversion. In this case, we could say, for example, phone call lead. And then we're gonna choose this option, calls from website visits. We're gonna click on setup over here, and we're gonna say someone calls a number shown on my site. So we're gonna come in here into our website. We're gonna take this number here, and we're gonna paste it. Notice that I'm not pasting the plus one because it's a toll-free number. I don't want the one to be replaced. I only want this number to be replaced. And then here is where you actually add the phone number that you want people to reach you to, because Google is going to replace that number with their number so that they can forward the calls and track and measure how long somebody has stayed on that phone call for. So let me just go ahead and add a real number here. So there you go. Now keep in mind, this is all just for illustration purposes, right? So don't try to call any of these numbers because they will not work. So let's click on use this event. And now we can come in here and click on settings once again and just confirm all the details here. So we can choose primary or secondary. For the call here, we can give this a name. So let's say phone call duration, let's say greater than 50 seconds. We want to track somebody who's been on the phone with us for over 50 seconds. And by the way, I'm showing you how to do both of these conversions. It doesn't mean that you need to do both or that you need to only do one of them. Find out what makes the most sense for you and implement that one, but you don't need to do both of them, all right? Over here, we're gonna keep this as is. We're gonna say one. All these phone details are already input from what we've added. And then we're gonna click on done. And then we can click on save and continue. And then if you don't have the Google Tag Manager option here, that's totally okay. We're gonna click on see event snippet. And then here is this account ID number, right? The same one that we've had for the previous conversion. And here, this one here, that is the code for this specific conversion or the value for this specific conversion. And by the way, we forgot to change the actual duration. So let me quickly show you how to do that. Let's click on finish. And if we come down here to phone call duration over 50 seconds, let's click here. Click edit settings, and then over here for the call length, this is where you would edit that duration, okay? So it's just something that I missed, but you can find it here as well. So 50 seconds, now this makes sense, right? We're tracking over 50 seconds. And then we're gonna click on done. And then we wanna click on tag setup over here, and then here you do see Google Tag Manager, but if you don't, if you just see install the tag yourself, you need to add these values, these two. So we can just click on download over here, just in case you don't have that Google Tag Manager option. Let's click this right here. And then these are the values we need. So let's hop back over into Google Tag Manager. Let's click on new over here. Let's give this a name. So let's say Google Ads, phone call greater than 50 seconds, for example, or however you want to name it. Add a little space there. For the tag configuration, this time we're gonna click on Google Ads, but we're gonna click on Google Ads calls from website conversion because Google's gonna be replacing our phone number, right? So the displayed phone number to replace is gonna be this one. Let's come in here, let's copy that. Paste it here, and then let's open our notepad and copy this here and copy this whole thing here, including everything before the underscore right there. Paste it here, and that should be it for the tag. Now for the trigger, we can set this on all pages, right? And you should see this all pages over here as the trigger, even if you haven't used Google Tag Manager before. If you click on plus, it should be here somewhere at the top. Okay, so we're gonna click on save and that should be it. So before we save the changes, let's first preview and make sure that this works, okay? So we're gonna test both of these and I'm gonna show you how to do that. So let's click on preview here and we're gonna enter our URL, which is here already. Let's click on connect. And then the first thing we're gonna test is the click, okay? So we wanna see if the click is being tracked. So it says here the tag assistant is connected. Let's go back to Google Tag Manager, sorry, this page here. And let's see what tags have fired. So the Google Tag AW, this is our Google Tag code that has fired. Don't worry about this code. I'm gonna show you how to check this, but what this says is that Google Tag has found the phone number on this page one time. And then I'm gonna show you how to actually test to make sure that it's gonna replace the number. But if you notice here, it's not tracking the phone call click, right? And that's correct because a click has not occurred yet. So let's come in here and let's actually click on the phone call here. Okay, let's click, boom. And let's come back here and we should see here, Google Ads phone call clicks, okay? So that is set up properly, congratulations. And you can see here it's being transferred to the correct Google Ads account, which starts with 111, if you recall, right? That was that Google Ads ID that we've been adding into our Google Tag Manager. If we come back here, for example, right? It's this code right here, 111, that symbolizes our account. So let's come back in here and back into this page actually, and we need to be able to check if Google is successfully able to identify this number and make a call, right? So the trick to this is we're gonna add a little command to the end of the website. So we're gonna add number sign, we're gonna say Google-WCC for website call conversions, debug. We're gonna hit enter, and then we're gonna refresh the page. And then you should see a little pop-up at the bottom of the page. And if we click on force, your phone number should be replaced with 999999999, right? Which indicates that Google has successfully identified the phone number and replaced it. And if you scroll down, you will notice it hasn't changed any other number here, only this one, right? So that's how you know that this call forwarding conversion has been set up correctly. And you also see it right over here, Google Ads phone call over 50 seconds, okay? So that is it for that. So let's leave the debug view, we're good here. One more thing we have to do is save the changes. So let's come in here and let's say Google Ads call conversion tracking. We're gonna say phone call clicks and phone call duration over 50 seconds. That's what we've set up. It's gonna be easier for you guys to refer back to this in case anything happens. There you go. And now you should see that latest change you did right over here. And that is all. So congratulations. If you click back over here, you should see both of these conversions here now. One is this phone call duration over 50 seconds, and the other one is this phone call clicks right over here, okay? And that is all. So that's how you set up call conversions here with Google Ads. If you guys found value in this video, I invite you to check out my new membership site at yvonnemata.com/marketing-blueprint, which contains over 50 hours of content of marketing A to Z for your business. And this specific section for Google Ads is part of the Tracking and Analytics Mastery, where I show you how to install the Google Tag Manager, Google Analytics, step-by-step, explaining every single step of the way, and part of the Google Ads Mastery, which is about 11 hours long, going over everything to do with Google Ads. And each of these different lessons here contains additional sub-lessons. So there's a lot of content for you guys as you go through step-by-step and as I explain every part of marketing online as it pertains especially to website building, paid ads, and tracking. So that is all for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one.